die, Lord, we get caught in our own sin. And it's all too easy to keep rolling with it rather than fight back our soul to recover. We ask that you would forgive us our sins and give us the strength not only to repent, but to atone, so that we might more fully embrace your will and seek to do your will. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Well, I'm proud of you. I only had one person look at me funny before worship. Generally, there's more of that. But I know the one person. It was Marty. Marty, why'd you look at me funny before worship?
Because you have your arm.
There we go. Somebody else. I'm wearing a big white dress. Generally, for those of you who aren't normally here Saturday night, I don't wear this thing. I wear it Sunday. Saturday night, I wear the collar. Sometimes long sleeves, generally short. But I forgot. And all of the prep for the fellowship event over there, and the lifting, and the baptism today, and the sermons, and blah, 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 excuse, excuse, excuse. We got to the beach. And I started working, and I realized, oops. So I'll just put on my all. Another pastor who was in the crowd, not you, the other one, said, wear it all. You'll be fine. Nobody will know. Except, I forgot my shoes. And I've got white athletic socks. And shorts. And on and on and on. I had to wash the chalk off my hand. And as it sits, if you aren't paying too close of attention, well, or you're here for the first time, well, he's a pastor. But I goofed. And I'm sorry. Thank you. But it's fitting. Because this is a lot like what Herod did. Herod is caught in a snowball of his own sin. Here's a guy who tried to do good way back when, but, well, his brother married this really nice girl, and he really liked her. And so Herod got his brother's wife. Now, if you're just meeting them, you wouldn't notice. And if you weren't there all the time, you wouldn't notice. But that was wrong in the eyes of God. And it turned out Herodias wasn't exactly all that she was cracked up to be in the first place. And so we have Herod, who's committed this sin and decides to keep going with it. And his wife has a grudge against John the Baptist, who Herod likes. Because he seems like a wise man. He's preaching things that Herod seems to appreciate. But she forces him to arrest John. So Herod snowballs a little more. And he arrests John, but he likes him. So he keeps him in his palace, and he goes to visit, and he talks with him, trying to protect him from his wife. Until he goes down the hill some more. Herod married his brother's wife, arrested John for no reason, kept him imprisoned, and then threw a party, that's fine, where he had his daughter perform and dance. And then he made a promise that he couldn't keep. Herod, contrary to what some things say, wasn't a true king. Herod was a tetrarch. He was a ruler of parts of lands. And so this kingdom that he's offering isn't really what we're thinking. And here he is. He's made a promise in front of all of his constituents, all of his power people, everything. Trying to put on a good face, a good party for his birthday, make everybody happy. And when he offers his daughter a reward for doing so well, he gets stuck. For she turns around, talks to his mom, or his wife, and then comes back and says, I want the head of John the Baptist. And now we can see where all of these sins have built up to. If John wasn't in prison, this couldn't happen. If she hadn't danced, this couldn't happen. If Herod hadn't promised, this couldn't happen. If. But that's how sin works, isn't it? We start off with one little thing. I'm sleepy. You can miss. They won't notice. Right. It's contagious. That's how sin works. It's so simple to start off and have a sin. But when we stop trying to atone for it, and we just let that sin live in our lives, it festers. And it builds. And it leads. And it attracts. And before you know it, well, the blessing of Christ is that no matter how far we've snowballed in our own sin, we still have hope. The hill becomes harder to climb back out of for atonement, for repentance, but there is always hope. Christ is always there when we are ready. Christ is always waiting for us to turn back. To say, I'm sorry. I've sinned. And to atone. Nothing that we do is unforgivable in God's eyes. Thanks to His Son, who came down to look us in the face, to live amidst our sin, to die on the cross, and to come back to show us the way to eternal life. The way to forgiveness. We sin. We sin more.